The 473-kilometer walk was flagged off at Parliament today by the Minister of State for Youth and Children Affairs, Sarah Mateke, with the intention of reversing the flow of child trafficking and unsafe migration, organized by the Dwelling Places to fundraise for street children shelter in Napark.
It hurts. This is why everyone is speaking with passion, and a lot of passion. When you see the children on the streets going through. We are talking about the Karamoja children. And as rightly said, the statistics indicate that 80% come from Karamoja region, but also the other 20% from other neighboring districts. These are Ugandan children, our children. So for all of them to lead the kind of life we are seeing on the streets, it is unacceptable. It is not good at all.
My grandmother was a volunteer for Terre des Hommes. She would be knitting a lot of things, like clothes or blankets, sell them on the market to gain some money for Terre des Hommes. Or she would go door to door to raise money. And sometimes I was allowed to join her. And I think that my grandmother showed me that we can all play our part, that we all play our part. Even the part you play is for children at the other side of the world, the other side of the globe. But as we said today, very often, all children are all children, our children, and we all have a responsibility to play.
Faith Nakut, the Napark District Woman MP, called on the government to step up accessibility and affordability of education in Karamoja sub-region as a measure to protect the girl child to keep in school and mitigate the push factors that drive them to the street.
Access and affordability of education must be looked into very seriously. For us, the members of parliament from Karamoja, we have made a demand to government that government offers free and compulsory education for all the Karamojong children, so that the question of tuition, uniform, whatever is required, the thing that our parents see as a burden, that question can be eliminated. And we have these children study for at least 15 years.
Street kids are not only social and health hazards to cities, but they are a big security threat, according to the Residential District Commissioner of Napark, Dennis Okori.
So if you do not see a problem with that, then you may never see the reason for this walk. If you are not angered, as a society, we must get angered. We must get angry at the suffering that the children go to just to reach Kampala. How many of us know what a four-year-old child looks like? Personally, I have done 6 rescues now. Personally. The times have changed. The trends have changed. How these children has changed. It used to be hard. It is now worse.
Okori noted that it's becoming difficult to intercept street kids while traveling to Kampala because they have resorted to walking over 20 kilometers and boarding buses after bypassing security checkpoints.
We used to intercept buses, we used to intercept taxis that were carrying these children. Now these children, because of the restrictions you have put on the transport sector, are forced to move over 20 kilometers to bypass checkpoints.
As efforts are being made to rescue and resettle street kids back to their homes, John Bosco Ngoya, the Bokora West MP, is concerned that the prevailing insecurity in Karamoja will not allow the campaign to succeed.
It's making worse even our journey. It's the conflict that the chairperson has actually alluded to. These children are many coming just because the atmosphere there is not for a child to grow. We've just been sharing with the chairperson. Every day there are reports of death. And I want to encourage those ones that are walking that you'll be safe. We've been there for the last 1 week. We've been talking to people from North Karamoja through to South Karamoja, telling them how each one of us has to contribute something, to talk to one another, to talk to those that cannot be able to listen. And we still have hope. And that's the reason why we are starting this journey of hope.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.